I always see the Lord near me, and I will not be afraid with him at my right side. Because of this, my heart will be glad, my words will be joyful, and I will live in hope. Acts 2:25-26. Dearest God, thank you for the blessing of your love through Jesus Christ. Our gratefulness continues in being your church. May we be sensitive to the promptings of your Spirit in making us the clear proof of your love and grace to all people. In Jesus' name, amen.
Cross my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. From the earth. to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. 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 Amen. Together. Lord, you said in your word, count it all joy when you meet various trials. And while that is a curiosity to us, we can still give you thanks. Why? Because of your continued love, care, and presence within our lives. We thank you so much for the gift of prayer and being able to communicate to you in whatever situation and whatever burden, as well as whatever praise we may have, because you hear us. We particularly give thanks for the blessing for Cindy McCarthy with the recent marriage of her grandson, Christopher Allen, to Laura Morgan in Tennessee. We're grateful that she had the chance for her to go and visit not only with the celebration, but also with family as well. It was also praise and blessing for Cindy to also meet her great-granddaughter, Isabel, also lovingly known as Izzy. So we are thankful so much for the blessing of even getting in touch with one another in so many ways, be it by video, phone, and especially in person. Oh Lord, we are saddened though when we hear about the situation of social unrest that is still going on, and how sad it is that the recent attention in our news has turned towards the violence that is happening in this country, especially towards the violence, gun shootings, that have killed children. We are saddened not only with the shooting that happened in Texas, but other related events. We think of the people in Tulsa at that hospital that were affected by that. Other areas as well too. We're saddened to hear of continued violence in this country for whatever reason. Vandalism, arson, and so forth. Lord, in your mercy, we grant your grace, especially with the social ills and the anger of people that draws them to cause much harm to so many. Lord, we don't always understand the background on this and also what brings people to that, but we also claim your intervention. We plead for your divine intervention if possible, as we also are thankful when law enforcement is able to, in other ways, are able to cause intervention to prevent such things from happening. We still, though, nonetheless commit to you the situation that is going on in the Ukraine with the war that is going on. We also pray for your grace upon the violence that is against your church in other parts of the world, and the steadfastness of our brothers and sisters to be remain focused on sharing your love, even to those who have yet to know and understand that you died even for them. Lord, we are also claiming your grace for those needing your extra tender loving care, of which we commit unto these persons at this time. For Ellie McQuarrie, for Cindy McCarthy's cousin Vijay, for Frank Bonchu, for John Kidd, for Dalton Chiesa, for Fran Chill. Lord, we commit unto you Sherry Hammer, Leroy Radanovich, Dan Warsinger, Barbara DeClue, Carol Williams, Ed Vagley, Edith DuPaul, and Emily Rust. Lord, we are also claiming your grace of comfort for the families of Barbara Shouten and Dwight Evans as they mourn their passing. We would also commit unto you those that we are still praying alongside with as they're dealing with the grief of their loved ones, for Bob Daniel, for Yvonne McKnight, for Frank Bartholomew, for Kathy Sutherland, and others who are grieving the recent passing of these loved ones. Lord, we are claiming your grace of the realities of COVID-19, that it is still alive and well and affecting people. We thank you so much for the resiliency as well as the adaptability, as well as the blessing of treatment and research, as well as prevention from this deadly disease. We pray for your ongoing grace of wisdom, choices, and gathering, as well as your grace in terms of continually adapting. And it is tiring to be able to do that, but we know that while these things change all in life, you never change and that you are with us. We are also claiming your grace for those recently affected by natural disasters, the fires that continue to rage on in New Mexico and Colorado. And even here, even though it may not be openly brought out in the news because it isn't as big, but it's still a threat and a reality. We claim your grace as we are dealing with another season of drought, and your grace upon even the slight hint and provision of precipitation. We are claiming your grace also for those facing major life changes, especially for those who are graduating from school, as graduations are already happening in the midst of all that's going on. We thank you for their accomplishment, and we're praying especially for high school and college graduates as they move on, not only in their achievement, but also in their maturity into adulthood. Provide open doors for whatever you would have them do and be, especially in the workplace and in other opportunities for their in advancement of their career and their lives. Thank you so much for the blessing of being mindful of your return, making the most of these days to share kindness and your grace and love. Other concerns as well as praises we commit unto you at this time, in this moment of quiet silence. Thank you so much for these things, O God, as we claim it in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Fresh on me, Spirit of
afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Melt me, mold me, fill me, use me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me.
Jesus went up on a mountainside and called to him those he wanted, and they came to him. He appointed 12 that they might be with him, and that he might send them out to preach, and to have authority to drive out demons. These are the 12 he appointed: Simon, to whom he gave the name Peter; James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. To them he gave the names, I might mispronounce this, Boanerges, which means sons of thunder; Andrew, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Heather, for the reading of God's word. The resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead was and is the highlight of our Christian faith. It set the excitement of what would happen next for the disciples. Before he ascended to heaven, Jesus gave instructions of continued ministry after he had gone. Two notable moments were when Jesus declared, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age." Matthew 28:18-20. This instruction is also known as the Great Commission. This reality of Jesus' presence, although not physically, was in the second notable moment when Jesus promised an even greater blessing. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth." Acts 1:4-5 and verse 8. One thing emerging from Jesus' direction was that believing in the Son of God would move beyond a Jewish sect to being a God-based faith where all people would be welcomed. This dramatically would be seen on the day of Pentecost. By its name, Pentecost is celebrated on the 50th day, the 7th Sunday from Easter Sunday. Beyond just a calendar number distinction, Pentecost is also known as the birthday of the church, although unlike Christmas, the date changes every year. In worship planning, this has led to developing a series on how to live for God by what we do, specifically in our speaking, in our hearing, in our seeing, and in our writing. Interestingly, this came about in looking at a classic cartoon of three monkeys with one covering the eyes, another covering the ears, and the third covering the mouth. The interpretation of this trio was monkey see no evil, monkey hear no evil, and monkey speak or say no evil. For our series, I added the with preposition and also included Right with No Evil, addressing the modern day social reality, the misused written word can be just as expressive of evil along with the spoken one. The Bible verses for our entire theme is from Romans 12. Love must be completely sincere, hate what is evil, hold on to what is good. Do not let evil defeat you. Instead, conquer evil with good. And that's verses 9 and 12 and 21 from Romans 12. For our speak with no evil, the familiar words of 1 Corinthians 13, 1 come to mind. I may speak in different languages, whether human or even of angels, but if I don't have love, I am only a noisy bell or a ringing cymbal. Let us pray. Thank you, O God, for your Holy Spirit that is anointing us, the same one at Pentecost that is anointing us with the blessing of hearing your word and working in our hearts and minds that we might be closer to you and to one another. In Jesus' name, amen. It was on Pentecost, today, that we remember the infilling of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles and other followers of Jesus Christ while they were in Jerusalem. The hope of great things to come happened on this day. Obedient to Jesus' instructions, his disciples were in Jerusalem all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. Note that Jesus' first disciples all came from the region of Galilee, different from other unique parts of Israel. Along with the color red, flames of fire are another symbol of Pentecost. Then there's the dove, symbolizing the Holy Spirit. This image goes back to the baptism of Jesus. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was open and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, whom I love, with him I am well pleased." Just to be clear, the other tongues or languages that the disciples spoke on Pentecost were human languages. This was God's perfect timing, as it just so happened that there was a festival in the city. There were staying in Jerusalem God-fearing Jews from every nation under heaven. It could be said that there was a global representation present, considering that only Jews were mentioned. From Acts 2:9-11, there is a list of the various languages spoken by Jesus' disciples that day. Those in the gathering crowd perked up with amazement as they heard a familiar dialect from their area fluently spoken by a Galilean not from their region. And yet, although there were many different languages the disciples were speaking, they were speaking the same message. It was a praise to God with special mention about Jesus Christ. Later, in Acts 2:14-40, Peter explains what has happened to him and the other disciples. Peter even gave a disclaimer that they were not drunk. The result, as Peter shared his experiences with Jesus, led to 3,000 persons believing in Jesus Christ on Pentecost. And that's in Acts 2:41. This was the start of a momentum that would continue and be described all throughout the book of Acts. We are a continued expression of that momentum to this day. What a blessing it was to celebrate our local heritage a few weeks ago with our ethnic heritage backgrounds. Since then, I've enjoyed the blessing of other diverse tongues spoken in this church. There is the language of repair, as some of our skilled men continued their work on the pathway to the inner sanctuary entrance. It is a language that continues with all the repair and maintenance work in our facility, and that also includes the parsonage. Then, there is a language spoken in our office, which scheduling, paperwork, and finances. We are further blessed with all the online worship preparation work as we communicate through AirDrop, apps, uploads, and downloads. For our in-person worship, we are working with keynotes, the red or black songbook, the hymnal, and the narthex. There is a language of outreach, as we know about our own being a church, being the Tuna Church, as we give to the Manna House and support other local groups such as Habitat for Humanity and the Heritage House, among others, in the Alliance. Then there is the language of music. I am so grateful for the abundance and variety and styles of music, be it through singing, chimes, dulcimer, duet, bluegrass band, piano and organ accompaniment, be it classical or contemporary music. Many, many tongues, but the same message of God's love and grace in Christ. Know also that in your own spheres of influence, you are in God-placed positions with unique languages and nuances, able to also share the message of God's love and grace to those regularly in your life. This is just a sample of how we are all world-versed in various languages. Yet, this is all part of the one message in creatively sharing God's love, care, and grace in Christ Jesus. The same Holy Spirit that filled the disciples thousands of years ago is still actively present and working in God's church, in you and me. We are empowered with his love and grace as we strive and continue to be building relationships in an ever-changing world that lasts for eternity. By God's grace, through our living Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And now the invitation to the offering. From God's love, grace, and generous giving, we have received so much. So now, out of gratitude and love for God, let us cheerfully give unto God.
Love is something if you give it away, give it away. Love is something if you give it away, you'll end up having more. It's just like a magic penny, hold it tight and you won't have any. But lend it, spend it, you'll have so many, they'll roll all over the floor. For love is something if you give it away, give it away, give it away. Love is something if you give it away, you'll end up having more. So let's go dance until the break of day, and if there's a piper, we will pay. For love is something if you give it away, you'll end up having more. Love is something if you give it away, give it away, give it away. Love is something if you give it away, you'll end up having more. Love is something if you give it away, give it away, give it away. Love is something if you give it away, you'll end up having more.
Thank you, God, for your love and grace most seen in the giving of your Son, Christ Jesus. In presenting this offering, along with our lives, bring us closer to you that we may be used to fulfill the bringing of your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors. We have not heard the cry of our need. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for you and I while we're yet sinners, which proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. The Great Thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. We're delighted to be in this place of sanctuary, here in the Spirit Garden at Mariposa United Methodist Church, knowing that you are here as well. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn, Holy, 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 Holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, freed us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night to which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink of this, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim that mystery of faith that Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. Thank you, O God, for your Holy Spirit poured in us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and cup, that they may be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry throughout the whole world, until you come again in final victory and we feast at your heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. In the United Methodist Church, we practice an open table. That is, anyone who is a believer, anyone who is seeking God's grace, is welcome to partake of the sacrament.
This child.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. And when I know, oh, I truly know, he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he lives. We are blessed in being the Mariposa United Methodist Church as we have worshiped God together even through this YouTube. Thank you so much for your ministry of presence as we've delighted in God's presence that is not only with us now, but always. Our ministry continues with this YouTube video, especially during this time when COVID numbers are still rising, and we make this available for anyone who would not be able to or choose not to be at our in-person worship at 9:30. We're also blessed also to be celebrating this month, particularly those who are graduating, as well as those who will be receiving Bibles, thanks to our TGIF ministry. But continue to be safe. Continue to be prayerful, especially with the news of so much violence going on, not only in places like Ukraine, but in this country. And always, always stay healthy, be kind, be prayerful, and know that God's peace and grace is with us all. Amen. Will you receive the benediction? Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen.
Where will we go and who will we be? We go out into the world to be God's children, to build relationships in an ever-changing world that lasts for eternity. Amen.
Twilight, dim be the region of fall. the deepening darkness, brighten the shimmering star. Then, when the night is upon us, why should the heart sink away? When the dark midnight is over, watch for the breaking of day.